Good rising, you guys. This is the pretty coach, Autochthonous Eris. Also, simply Judea here. It is going to be a general energetic. Well, it's the rising reading. It's about 6 a.m. in the morning. Okay. I've already prayed and set the intentions for this reading. And they are that we basically get whatever insight spirit has for us at this time for our highest good. And this is for both myself and the collective. And I just figure I'm a part of the collective, and it's for people who are like me. Jeez Louise, first card out. Give me a minute. Fairies. Fairies is here, and it says you have a strong bond with the fairies, and your life purpose involves helping Mother Nature. Okay, so that's gonna be the end of that card deck. I think I don't want to pull anymore. At the bottom of the deck, it says solar plexus chakra. It says it is safe for you to be powerful and take charge of your life in positive ways. So I'm gonna sit this to the side. All right, let's get a traditional tarot card. I'm gonna get more of these because I want a story to be told here. All right, so I am back, you guys. Please forgive me. I have like phlegm and stuff coming up. All right, the Six of Cups is here. So this could have something to do with childhood, emotional situations and scenarios. It could have something to do also with just someone from like a childhood friendship, childhood sweetheart. You know, a beloved child, but this also deals with the soulmate energy. So this could be like the way that I'm seeing this card today, it's giving vibes of maybe two people recognizing each other for the first time, it feels like. And maybe taking the time to kind of share their feelings. Okay, that's what I'm seeing there with that card. Let's get some more spirit, show us more. I see the Six of Pentacles, which is giving very heavy, heavy karmic energy, something that's fated, destined to happen. We have the Six of Pentacles. There could be in these conversations or in sharing of the feelings, someone's talking about reciprocity, someone's talking about maybe something not being as give and take as they would prefer, or as someone who they're connected to would prefer. I see the Justice card here, heavy on the Libra energy. But justice is about truth. Justice is about, like, the phrase I feel like saying is, what was supposed to happen is happening. Or there's going to be a way to where what was always intended to happen will be. And truth about that, clarity about that, understanding about that, I feel will be made clear. We got two cards with scales here. You know, this Six of Pentacles is here as well. heavy on the karma, heavy on the fated and destined energy. For us who are going to be affected by these energies, you're not going to be able to avoid this. You cannot skip over this particular thing. The sword is the sword of truth and clarity, which does bring about balance. This is restoration. Now, I will say that in this particular card, the scales actually are not balanced. The scales aren't balanced here. So it makes me feel like something may not be fair. Even if it's the truth, or even if it's fated and meant to happen, it gives me vibes of, or it's possible that the reason that the scales are currently unbalanced is because this information hasn't come out yet. these realizations, or something hasn't been made completely clear yet, and that's the reason for the imbalance here. Okay, let's look at the bottom of the deck. I see the victory card with the Six of Wands, another six. So 666 is going to be significant. The number six could be significant. I see the Nine of Cups here. So this fated situation could come as a yes answer to a prayer. It could also come as like a wish fulfillment. Okay, and then at the bottom of the deck, I see the Five of Swords here, and this is about strategy. This is about, I don't know why I'm feeling like weighing pros and cons, because traditionally, the Five of Swords is just, it's for sure strategy, mental strategy, okay? Someone getting their thoughts, their communication together. I'm even hearing collecting data with this. Somebody, there could have been some conversations where you were collecting information, okay? But this is also a card about people who are willing to maybe kind of fight a little ugly, fight nasty, or that they are people who like to have like the last word, or they want to have the upper hand, and it doesn't matter. Excuse me. And it doesn't matter who they hurt when they're in this particular energy. Kind of saying anything to get a rate a rise out of people, to have a, like a cutting tongue here. That could be energy as well. Also, competing mentalities, and somebody's is going to come out on top. So this is the overall energy. I also see the King of Swords at the bottom of the deck, so that can deal with an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libra. We are in Aquarius season right now, and just Pluto is an Aquarius. This can really point to anything here, okay? We're going to clarify these. Let's move these off to the side as they are our overall energy cards. All right, Spirit, show us more about this Six of Cups, Six of Pentacles, and this, this Justice card, as well as the overall energies as well. But first here, Spirit, why is the Six here, the Six of Cups? We have the Seven of Cups here. So the Seven of Cups is usually about a need to make a decision. Sometimes this is about a need to get out of one's head. A need to get out of one's head, okay? All right, please excuse me. All right, so yeah, this is about, could be about the need of someone to get out of their head. This also could be that someone has options, or someone's trying to make a decision on what way to go. somebody could be in their dream. This could be indicative of dreams. So heavy dream activity here. Okay. Let's see. Let's get some more information. Show us more, Spirit, about this Six of Cups energy, please. I have the Page of Pentacles. So it's possible, and this is in my past energy, but time is fluid, so this could go either way. In the past, someone could have met a partner that was an energetic soul match in some kind of way, and somebody made a decision that was different from normal. I think that normally somebody would have been in their head a lot, in their feelings a lot, in their imagination, and the change that they made was to try to get real. Okay, with the Page of Pentacles here, which was something new for them. Things begin to move very, very quickly and passionately between this connection with the Eight of Wands. Now we have this period of separation that could be upon them now, or this could have happened after a time of separation for somebody, or maybe even for both parties involved. This could also indicate a need for a vacation or the need for some form of rest after going fast or working so much. Show me more about the Six of Cups energy before I move on. More about the Six of Cups spirit before we move on. There has been a lot of conflict, maybe, in this scenario, a lot of fighting, heated discussions, competition, even. Maybe even a lot of negotiations with this connection. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius is noted here. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Libra, Aquarius, or Gemini, and of course, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. So all the elements are represented here. A vibe I'm also feeling is that somebody could be trying to weigh their options here. They could already be in a karmic connection. There may be conversations about some things that either both parties or one party may feel is missing, and it could lead to a lot of changes happening very quickly in the dynamics of this relationship. Okay, it could lead to competition because someone may say, hey, I want to try out, I want to date other people, or I want to see where this particular thing can go. And that may cause for a lot of argument, debate. Excuse me. I also feel like with this fairies card here, I think that it really may do well for some of us to just get outside and sit in nature. Like, if we are having to make a choice, having to make a decision, I feel like that may really, really help us with making the choice. Okay, let's move on to the Six of Pentacles spirit. Please show me the Six of Pentacles energy. First card I saw was the Fool card, but the Ace of Wands is what hit the table first. So someone's looking to go in a new direction. Okay, here's another message that I feel like I'm getting. I feel like these sixes could be representing two different connections. There's one where there's a meeting of like feelings and emotions and meeting of heart minds, right? But with this Six of Pentacles, there could be a meeting of resources, okay, or other like feelings could actually be real here. The Six of Cups, feelings are fleeting. They can come and they can go. They can be rooted in childhood things, which may not come across always as realistic. So, but with the Six of Pentacles, it's giving the realistic vibes. It's giving. I feel like in this matter, this was about giving of feelings and compassion and love. And this Not to say that that won't be the case at all, but I really feel like this right here is going to be more along the lines of giving tangible things, like maybe both parties giving tangibly. Okay. But anyway, we have the Ace of Wands and the Fool here. So something is going to either these two cards are about one single relationship or it's about two different ones. And somebody is getting ready to go in a new direction. There's about to be a new beginning. Someone's taking a leap of faith, a risk here. I feel like it is moved by their passion here. There's a lot of strong chemistry here with this Ace of Wands. This could also sometimes be a phallic symbol, but this is just with the Six of Pentacles. But all of this reading is connected, so let's keep it pushing. Somebody may even go into a new field of work, you guys. Whoa. The Five of Cups in reverse could indicate, excuse me, the ending of a depressive energy. It could be the ending of drinking, or other forms of addictive things that happens. I also feel like the end of depression, the end of grief, the end of heaviness here. And that is so amazing. That's a beautiful energy. I also probably need to get the traditional understanding of that. Oh no, I'm gonna stick with what I said. Because we have the Ace of Cups here, you guys. This is about, I feel like someone could experience a major spiritual awakening. And I also feel like this is about to be an offer of love, whether it is brand spanking new, like you and this person has never met, or if it is going to in fact be someone whom you have met before or that you're currently with, but that relationship gets like a makeover. Ooh, that's some heavy, good energy though. I clarifying this one first though? Oh, no, I didn't. This is the second day. Oh, please forgive me. Oh, wow, that's beautiful energy. Spirit, is there any more for this Six of Pentacles energy? Guys, I'm seeing the Hierophant here. So this could be connected to the sign of Taurus or just Taurian energies, you guys. So someone could propose, someone could get married, or bare minimum, someone could get into a more committed relationship here. Someone's gonna go from just like, see, and remember I told you guys about resources here, right? Not just feelings and love, you know? Not that our love is beautiful, but if we cannot build something that is useful, then I'm telling you, I finally understood why Tina can say, what's love got to do with it? Because you know what your feelings can have you doing? You could deeply love somebody. You guys can deeply love each other. But if you have wounds or if you're unable to provide like assistance to one another in real ways, then it's almost like it doesn't matter. It's like it's just a vapor. Another thing I wanted to say was love and emotions can have you going up and down, up and down. You guys can love each other one minute, hate each other the next, or you can always love each other, but the way that it shows up could be in the form of hatred or strong dislike. Okay, so love ain't all there is. But love with along with things that are useful with each other, that can get people somewhere. And it's looking like with this Six of damn pentacles, baby, somebody's coming in and they're coming in as like a charitable person, a person who has resources to truly offer to this benefactor. That's what I feel is happening here. And because of that, someone is going to, I think marriage is going to be on the table. I also think that schooling, higher education is somewhere in here. But there's going to be a commitment, at least talked about, okay? Even if it doesn't really happen, this is going to be part of the conversation. Let's see what this Justice card is here for. First card out the deck, Six of Pentacles. So it feels like it's just kind of clarifying that energy over there. Ooh, you guys. this Six of Pentacles also deals with charity, giving to the less fortunate, you know. And that can happen both in a community setting, or that can sometimes happen in actual relationships. Like somebody may be able to give to a connection more than another person at one point in time was. And I mean, we've got these scales here and they're balanced. This could be about being a philanthropist, okay? All right, we got a lot of cards coming out there, I think. I'm gonna start with this one. We have the Six of Swords here, which can talk about someone literally moving on. It can talk about somebody moving on. There's a mother with a child on here, and there is a person driving the boat, okay? I don't know why, but I low-key get a rescue air about this. Like, and even if it's not a rescue, if this woman rescued herself, you know, with her child, this person here is an integral part of her moving on to smoother, calmer, waters and mentality. This is like peace of mind card for me, but it's also spiritual journey here, okay? I see here the Three of Wands. It's like somebody has been waiting for this. It could be the woman here, or it could be the woman and another person. Spirit, show me more. There's an air of expectation. Somebody could have been waiting for this particular boat or ship to come in. It's almost also like this person, like the way I'm looking at these two cards, it's as if this person is waiting on this. So they're like at the banks of the river, just waiting for these people to arrive. I don't know. But the Three of Wands could be an air of suspension, okay? Suspense, waiting. Okay, waiting on something to happen. I'm seeing the Sun card here. The sign of Leo is connected to this for sure. But if it's not about Leo, this is about success, guys. This is about clarity. This is about finally feeling like you're your total full self. This could also have something to do with confidence. I heard confidence in the connection. Okay, the next card here, I see the Queen of Swords, but in the reverse. So, to me, I guess this would be someone who had received clarity. Maybe they cut off what was no longer serving them already, or they have spoken a truth that needed to be spoken. This could absolutely indicate divorce. Or walking away from a relationship that, if the logic, please excuse me, that if the logic and reason were applied just as much as love and feelings, it may not have stood. It may, the feelings may not have been enough. Okay. All right. Spirit, is there anything more with this Justice card? Somebody could return as well. Like if there was a divorce or if there was a separation, some of you guys could potentially return. That may not be for everybody. Two of Pentacles is about, to me, getting priorities together, having a maybe having a working to find a work and life balance. See, traditionally, this person is on a log, which would really indicate juggling or trying to juggle. But this person is standing on solid ground in this picture. You guys cannot see this, and I do apologize, but the person is standing on solid ground. They are a little off kilter with the fact that they're walking and taking steps, but I also see the infinity symbol here, the infinity symbol. So that'll be something that I think we constantly have to work to do. This is also giving me give and take energy, a going back and forth with the resources, finances, even real feelings. I really want to look into this Queen of Swords in reverse, so I'm going to pick up another tarot deck. Give me a moment. And I need to do this quickly so that I can be ready for when my dear sweet baby wakes up. All right, let's get into this. Why is the Queen of Swords here in reverse, spirit? Please reveal that energy to us so that we can be very, very clear. Because the whole purpose of tarot readings is to provide clarity and more understanding. So this is what we're asking for, God. Give us the energy surrounding this Queen of Swords in reverse. This could also possibly, indicate the loss of control, I feel. Or the giving up of control. Or maybe somebody who wasn't operating in this energy of speaking their truth. Okay, let's see. Spirit, please show me why is this Queen of Swords here? Why is the Queen of Swords here, God? Come on, Holy Spirit of Wisdom. Thank you so much for all the messages that you've shared. Okay, yeah. So the seven, or sorry, the Eight of Swords is here. So someone could have felt stuck, but this is where the Sun card is coming in. This is where the success or the clarity is coming. This person either is going to have be in this energy of feeling bound, feeling stuck, bare minimum mentally. We have two cards revealing themselves. Let's see what they are. I see the Four of Pentacles. I feel like maybe this lady or male, whoever it is, was trying to hold on. I even feel like they were trying to save something, save the connection, you know? They were trying to hold on, but I don't know if it was working out for them. I have the Ace of Swords here, clarity, which we already said that for the Leo energy, but it's also very possible that what I'm seeing here is there could be a situation where there was talks about leaving and talks about divorce or talks about, getting away to find clarity, but in the end, somebody could remain in a connection because they find out the truth about it, or because the truth was spoken, things may begin to shift and change as they always should have been. Let's get into this before I move on. Let's do the sun because I think that's going to help out too. Show me the sun energy, spirit. What's happened to bring this clarity, this happiness, this joy, this success, this feeling most like one's authentic self, this power, this confidence? I see the Five of Swords here, which is that energy of confrontation or strategic communication or, negotiations, even. The Three of Swords. This is about confusion in matters of the heart mind. there could be a third party scenario that is discovered, okay? Or that someone shares information about that could bring a heaviness, a heartbreak, if you will. This could also indicate a breakup. And then we have the Temperance card, Sagittarius energy showing up right here. But this could also have something to do with patience, okay? So all of these are also swords. Both of these are swords cards. So this could really be in, this could be an internal battle of someone's mind, someone's thought processes, okay? But this could also be communications of all sorts. We could really talk to one another about what we're feeling and what's going on. Temperance is about respecting. It's about patience. It's about I think even respecting the people's processes or respecting how things work. It could also be about expansion and growth. So I don't know, you guys. Let's see, Spirit, is there anything more about this Sun card here before we move on? It's the King of Swords. The King of Swords. The King of Swords is showing up here, Aquarius, Gemini, Libra energy. I feel like someone is either going to mature or this is going to be someone who's coming in who is already in this energy of maturity. They are a clear communicator, able to express themselves. No mind games here. I feel like now it makes me feel like someone's going to come in talking about a fucking plan. They're going to talk about what should happen, what they plan to do, and da 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 da. And it's going to leave some other people in the dust. It's going to leave this person, this king here, with the upper hand. That's for sure. That's what I feel. This person could have something to do with law enforcement, police officer, military, a lawyer, a public speaker, a teacher, even. But whoever this is, I really feel like they're gonna bring some form of order and structure to a scenario. Let's get on over here to this Two of Pentacles. Why is the Two of Pentacles here, Spirit? Show us the energy of the Two of Pentacles. I see this card trying to come out, so I'm gonna just show that to you guys. The Queen of Wands. That's Aries, Leo, Sag energy. Oh my God, I feel like somebody is gonna say that you are my priority, or I'm gonna take responsibility for you. Like I'm willing to take on responsibility. Ooh, this is a lot of cards trying to file today. It's gonna happen. Let's try this again. Spirit, show us why. Okay, or it could be that this Queen of Wands energy gains the confidence to prioritize what's important and significant to her. I'm gonna take this too, but this will be the last card. This may have hit the table first, so let's see here. Page of Wands. So this could deal with a child, who is Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy, or this could deal with a message or a conversation. The Queen of Wands is confident. The Queen of Wands is beautiful. The Queen of Wands, is able to. Once she makes up her mind, she is able to accomplish whatever. Okay, she's gorgeous, she's powerful in her own right, very intuitive. Somebody is going to make either someone's going to talk, she's going to be talking, or someone's going to be talking to her. We also have the Moon card here. So this might be something that the Queen of Wands doesn't even see coming. The moon can discuss information that's coming up, okay? Emotional shit that comes up to the surface that needs to be addressed. It can also indicate secrets, things that are hidden. And now I'm gonna look at this card because this was the last one. This is the Justice card. I have a feeling that whoever this woman or male is, this justice that's coming, I think they had missed this before. I think it's all gonna come full circle. They're gonna understand why everything played out the way that it did. That's what I feel like is going to happen. And I feel like finally, someone is going to feel like their life is finally in order now. Once all of this begins to happen, someone's going to understand why this had to play out this way. So many different things. Like the vision that I'm getting in my mind right now is like if you're watching a really good movie and the movie does these flashbacks towards it's not the very end, but it's like it's a climactic event that, especially in a romance movie, where like this woman finally, it finally clicks to her why all the other relationships didn't work out, and it points to the one person who was there all along, or who was there for her, or wanted to be there for her all along. And this could, be for a guy as well. I will say that the movie Baggage Claim came up to me yesterday sometime, just in my own thoughts. So that could be somehow significant to this reading. But the point I'm making, you guys, is that that's the what I'm feeling with this Justice card coming out. And mind you, Justice already came out in this other deck. So yeah, it just makes me feel like some shit is really gonna be full circle and it's really gonna make a lot of sense. Spirit, is there anything more before I move on from this card? What else is going on here with this Two of Pentacles? Yep, Six of Swords. Someone's gonna be moving on, and I feel like this is moving on from a different phase in life because of their shift in their mind. This is my mental clarity. This is my peace of mind card. This is a spiritual journey, but this could also have something to do with a cruise or a trip by boat or a trip over the water. This could have something to do with trips by water or something. But I really, really feel like, and this time, this appears to be, never mind, it's still probably a guy. But look at this color. You guys may not be able to see this really good, but this color, this cloak is green, literally the color of my nails. Lord. Okay, at the bottom of the deck, I see the Seven of Cups here. So this is a need to make a decision. And we've got a lot to choose from. This could be the need to cut through illusion, you guys. To cut through illusion. I do feel like someone's going to be able to do that because this is going to be connected to my victory card here, which was at the bottom of the deck. It was part of the overall energy. So someone will gain victory in this decision-making process. I have with the yes energy or the wish fulfillment energy, I am seeing the Four of Wands, which for me is heavy on marriage energy, reception energy, community building. Look at those beautiful doves there, guys. This is like twin flame stuff for real. Like, I've looked up the meaning of two doves on purpose because I was, and it was when I was in another connection. Okay. Now, this is going to get a little personal for me, but I have to share it. I feel the need to share it. I was in a former relationship. The last and final card before I move on is the Five of Wands, and this is clarifying or atop the Five of Swords. So five, five is going to be very significant. And at the very bottom, we have the Three of Wands here. This is expected. This makes me think about Jeremiah 29 and 11 when it says, for I know the plans that I have for you, plans to prosper you and to give you an expected end. That could be significant for some of you guys. But back to this Four of Wands card. When I was living with a man back in Ohio, which was a karmic lesson that I needed to learn, I wound up seeing, I was parked in our driveway at the time in a car, and I wound up seeing two, what appeared to be like two doves. They both flew and landed on this fence that surrounds his property. And I was looking and I'm like, is that two doves? I had to Google it to remind myself of what doves look like because pigeons and doves can look the same to me. And in fact, it was the doves. It was the doves. And pigeons and doves are like either the same family or they're like cousins. So all in all, it was two doves. They were both white birds with these delicate, gentle faces. And when I looked up, because when I saw that, first of all, I knew that that was something significant. Intuitively, I just felt like, oh shit, this is important. We do not see this very often. Let's see what this is about. So first, I clarified whether it was doves or not, or if it was pigeons. It was doves. And then I went to go look up what is the metaphysical meaning between doves. And darn it, I dropped the card. And what I did, I found that basically it could be connected to twin flames. It is connected to love and peace and harmony within relationships. There are other spiritual meanings of those, but it was important, I guess, at that time for me with matters of the heart and love and relationships because of the relationship I was in at the time. All in all, I had thought that me and that person were probably twin flames. Not to say that we were or we weren't, but I don't think so anymore. I feel more so like that was just a connection that was meant for me to have. I will say, however, the other reason why I think that's significant for me personally is because while I was with that gentleman, I did have a dream that included another male from my former life who, in the dream, that young man was telling me how I deserve so much better than what I was accepting at that time in that relationship. Okay. And I remember not understanding why it was him. And it was his energy for sure. I knew who this energy was. I didn't see any face or anything, but who this person was, I knew. I knew who it was. So, and I think it's cool because that person was, or I mean, he's literally born under the sign of Aquarius. So that's like, to me, the King of Swords energy here. And he does also have affiliations to, certain things. I'll share more later as I'm led to, but yeah, that's this portion of the reading. Let's go ahead and at the bottom of the deck, I do see the Seven of Wands here. So this is gonna have to be able, this is gonna be an energy of having to fight for and stand for what you believe in, no matter what, even if you're by yourself. But this is also somebody having an advantage, okay? Having a vantage point. That could also deal with slander and things like that. So be ready for that. Let's get the encouraging words of Jesus, and then I'm gonna let you guys go. All right, so I'm gonna stop there because that's about three cards. First card to hit the table is this one. It says this: heal the sick that are therein, and say unto them, the kingdom of God is come nigh unto you. To me, this is could be very well about physical ailments, but I also feel like this is mental ailments, okay? Like, this could be for people to actually teach what the kingdom is and show people how close it is to them. The next card here is, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you shall say unto this mountain, which actually indicates an obstacle or a blockage, remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove. So this is talking about the power that we have. Christ is trying to tell us, about the powerful beings that we are here. And that deals with confidence too. This deals with confidence too, the power to manifest, the way that you need to. Remember in this particular deck right here where we got the fairies card, the solar plexus chakra was at the bottom of the deck. And this is what it said, it is safe for you to be powerful and to take charge of your life in positive ways. So this really could be something here, guys. Somebody's gonna have to have the courage to make this choice. It could be hurtful. It's not going to be easy, but someone's got to make the choice. The King of Swords was at the bottom of the main tarot deck too, once I had pulled all the other cards for the overall energy. So can't get away from this King of Swords right now. And last but not least, we have the Seek and You Shall Find card. So seeking could be like in the form of readings, it could be prayer, it could be meditations, it could even be actually having conversations where you're gathering information. Okay? You're gonna find out what you want to know. And if it's merely about you trying to get an understanding for yourself, if you ask your angels, if you ask God Most High, the Lord has angels who are ready and willing to minister to us, to serve us in whatever capacity we need help. So if this is about you, if this resonates with you, if you have not yet asked God to help you figure this out, to sort through all the information, sincerely ask for that. If this is more so about you wanting to get clarity with a person that you're dealing with, then ask the questions that you feel like you really desire the answers to. Get the confidence to ask these questions, and maybe you'll receive clarity even quicker. Okay? And will it be what you want to hear? It may not be. And it may be what you want to hear. But all in all, I do believe that it's supposed to lead to more clarity. So, without further ado, that is the reading, guys. At the bottom of the deck, I see whatsoever things you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them and then you shall have them already. It also says, thou shalt love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. That's loving yourself. That's loving yourself that way. And when you love yourself that way, you'll love other people that way. Last but not least, it says, peace be unto you as my Father hath sent me. Like my Father sent me here in peace to you. And remember, that's definitely making me think about that old, good old, that Six of Swords. The Most High desire that we have peace of mind, you guys. And you get peace of mind when the truth is in there, when you've got clarity about everything that's happening, everything that has happened, and maybe even where you currently are or where you're headed. You get peace of mind when you understand the truth about things. At the very bottom, and I'm going to leave you guys alone. It says, unto you it is given to know the mystery of the kingdom of God. Like, somehow this pose is very significant. And those colors, blue and white and yellow, orange. I wouldn't be surprised if some of you guys, or maybe even myself, if we find ourselves in position with someone like this, or if we are people who like to look up and gaze at the stars. All right, guys, peace, love, light, and darkness, which all work together to bring balance and harmony, first within ourselves and then within our world. If you're new to the channel and you love this reading or you like the way that I read, go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. Comment below your thoughts on this reading. And then also, if you haven't subscribed, be sure to go ahead and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, bye.